Go, Tina, go, Tina, go, Tina, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
go, go. Look at her go, Elf Tina. We got Elf Betty, we got me Santa down here, Old Strathcona Antique Mall. And you know, Betty, our third and final question for Santa. Now, we've already covered how do I get to every house.
Yeah.
We mentioned my twin brother, Larry Claus, down in the South Pole.
Mrs. Claus,
when we talked about the snow sausages.
That's a great
What's
idea.
The big third question for Santa?
Okay, so Santa, we know that you're really busy leading up to Christmas, and of course Christmas night, you and Larry, apparently. So what about during the off season? Where do you go? What do you do during all those other months?
That's a darn good question, because a lot of people don't know this. It's a secret. Mm-hmm. What happens? We shut down after Boxing Day.
Okay.
And then, of course, we got that lull, but we got those elves there. They're industrious. You can't just stop everything.
Okay.
So what we do is we pick up a couple of contracts.
Oh.
And I keep those little guys going, because I'll tell you, if you shut down, there's nothing to do. The cargo plane comes in with a bit of, you know. There's trouble up there.
I got that problem with Elf Tina.
Yeah. And what I do is I kind of sometimes leave Mrs. Claus and I head south down to Fort McMurray. It's pretty warm there for me. Yeah, and I like to go down there and just tour around those tar sands. But But I'm in disguise, so nobody knows. But that's what I do, yeah, and we keep them busy up there. Fantastic. Oh, and you know what? Speaking of all that, now that everybody knows my secrets, and I'm here a little early in Edmonton, and we're talking toys, and that's one of the big things we make up the North Pole, and a lot of this stuff brings back memories for me. Because I remember making that one. And that one, and that one, and all these old collectible toys. They just get Santa going. Okay, I'm all right now.
Okay.
So this is popular, I would imagine, there, Betty.
This is really popular, not just for the little kids, Santa, but the older ones, too.
Because it's bringing back memories.
Absolutely. The people that were kids when you made the toys for them, now they're collecting them again. Things like, look at these little things. Do you remember, Santa, you made these? And sometimes they also showed up in Jello containers,
Jello, and there was airplanes and cars. They were collectible
wheels. All kinds of stuff.
I remember making those. The elves had we had the assembly line going big time for those.
Yeah, now people are throwing stocking stuffers. They're collecting the sets. Oh, look at, do you remember making this old car, Santa?
Oh, look, of course I do.
Yeah.
I remember when Mrs. Claus said that, she said, hey, Santa, maybe we can go for a ride later. Know what I mean?
53 Corvette.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic.
Look at that.
Look, that's a beauty. No, it does bring back memories, but you know, people out there, you got to remember, Santa's got to update. The kids used to have Corvettes and those little wheels. Now it's iPods and iBombs and I don't even keep up. It's my younger elves, they're the ones that keep up on the technology, but we're on top of stuff. We're on top of stuff. Well, that's great, Betty. All sorts of great stuff here. I sure have fun. We're going to be back to wrap up the show. We got a special Christmas song for you at the end of the show. We're going to bring in Elf Tina. You're going to be here, Santa. I'm going to sing that song, and then I'm back up to the North Pole till Christmas. So don't go away. Go, Edmonton, go.
After the break, I tell you what you need to know about football gear.